Hi, my name is Ovidius and I'm a sysadmin and DevOps engineer here at Oxylabs. In today's video, we will introduce the definitions of SOX and HTTP proxies, explain their reasons for using each type, and overview their differences. Let's get started. HTTP proxies are specifically made for HTTP connections, implementing the inherent proxy functionality of the HyperText Transfer Protocol, or HTTP. They operate via the same client-server model and are meant for proxying HTTP web requests. HTTP proxies, operating on the HTTP layer, have access to the content transferred by the protocol. Thus, traditionally, HTTP proxies were commonly used to facilitate access restrictions, more specifically firewalls, and caching web data for local users, often employees in a company network or students on the university campus. Stay tuned for more in-depth coverage on HTTP proxies in the near future. SOX proxies work with a multitude of transfer protocols. However, unlike HTTP proxies, SOX cannot interpret transfer data. If you are interested to know more about SOX proxies, please click on the card in the top right corner or follow a link in the video description where I explain a more in-depth outlook on the topic. Now let's shift our focus to the reasons why each proxy type is beneficial in its own specific way. HTTP proxies are a reliable choice for businesses that need to cover numerous goals and use cases. Here are the five main reasons to use HTTP proxies. First, data manipulation. By operating as a middleman between a client and its destination, HTTP proxies can be set up for content filtering or web data caching. Adding to the previous point, since they're able to inspect data in traffic, HTTP proxies can add an additional layer of advanced security while reacting and denying suspicious data packets, such as spyware or ill-mannered content that is about to enter the destination HTTP server, or vice versa. HTTP proxies can also be used to add or modify HTTP request headers to improve access to restricted targets and lower your chances of getting blocked, increasing your scraping success rates. In many cases, HTTP proxies can provide results faster. For example, achieving more requests per second for a given target. Lastly, since HTTP proxies implement the same HTTP protocol the web is used to, with a focus on proxying, it can be easier to understand and use for developers using it and/or implementing it in your system. Moving on to the next type, SOX proxies are compatible with most network protocols or ports, therefore they can be used in multiple applications and in a wealth of scenarios. Here are the three main reasons to use SOX proxies. First, anything can be fitted to work with it. SOX 5 proxies supports arbitrary forms of traffic, allowing software that doesn't directly cooperate with proxying to be encapsulated in a SOX 5 tunnel. Some rare software clients or very specialized systems may only support SOX proxies. Expanding on the compatibility further, SOX proxying can be applied to software that doesn't normally support any type of proxy configuration using so-called SOXifiers. I elaborate on this particular aspect in our SOX proxy video mentioned previously. Finally, SOX proxies work well with high volume undertakings. SOX 5 is often used for high volume applications such as batch email traffic using SMTP or even UDP-based video streaming. Now that we know the specific reasons to use the two proxy types, let's find out the main differences that determine their specific use case scenarios. We have divided the differences into three main categories: security, functionality, and performance. Let's take a look. SOX proxies don't have standard tunnel encryption, while HTTP proxies can add security in multiple forms. Tunnel encryption, using the same implementation as the one in HTTPS, can be used to prevent data from being spied upon and modified in transit by malicious elements. Additionally, data inspection can be used to detect and deny suspicious data packets or spyware. SOX proxies are more flexible to deploy as they are not bound to specific network protocols and can work with a wider variety of applications. HTTP proxies, while being limited to handling HTTP traffic, excel at it. They can interpret network traffic between web servers and clients. HTTP proxies can be set up to filter, cache, modify, and append web data. SOX proxies offer great payload throughput, making them ideal for downloading or transferring huge chunks of data via the internet. HTTP proxies deliver decent load speeds and excel at requests per second for standard-sized HTTP requests. The final choice depends on your use cases and needs. As a rule of thumb, if you're making standard-sized HTTP or HTTPS requests and or want to inspect, react to, and modify data at the proxy level, HTTP proxies should fit your needs best. SOX, on the other hand, may be a reliable choice for projects that involve downloading and transferring large amounts of data. In fact, SOX are the only choice if you're making network requests other than HTTP. I hope this video helped you understand the main differences between SOX and HTTP proxies and gave you an idea where to apply each type based on its characteristics. If you have any questions about proxies or would like to know more about related topics, feel free to contact us at hello@oxylabs.io or simply leave a comment below. If you appreciate our content, hit that like button as well as share this video on your social media. Thank you for tuning in. This was Oxylabs, and we hope to see you next time.